wish it was straighter.
Yeah. Okay.
I just got
greetings, everybody. Oh, okay. We're here for the fourth chapter of Twilight Chorus. We're in the fifth chapter of Twilight Chorus. We are here to continue our adventure through the depths. But first, let's introduce ourselves, starting to the left, my left.
Hello, my name is Lynn. I play a rogue named Linja.
Oh yeah, I was just gonna paint
her. There she is. I just painted her.
Let me see her up close.
Oh, it's not like finished, but I started. She has little daggers and a little cloak and.
Where are our cameras at?
My craftsmanship probably shouldn't be that macro shotted, but.
I don't know how to zoom, so.
Oh, perfect.
We'll take a picture later.
Great.
I am James. I play Einhorn, the tiefling bard. The tieflings look like demons, so as a tiefling, Einhorn decided to soothe his way through the world by becoming a bard. It just so happens that he sucks at it, but he's the only one who doesn't know that. So, yeah, he's an interesting guy.
And he still has cantrip his rapier. Okay.
Right. Oh, yeah.
I'm Paul. I play the tiefling who doesn't really care what other people think about tieflings. His name is Rizel. He is the warlock. He is pretty much utilitarian for the rest of the group. He just kind of wandered on, and I'm not really sure why I follow these guys.
It's fantastic.
But I'm a great walkie-talkie.
And that brings us to Nebo. I am Dragonborn. I'm a fighter. I have not painted mine yet, but I will. And so far, I am pretty good at taking some damage.
You forgot your friend.
Oh, yeah. And my boy. Chip Skull.
He's backwards.
He's backwards.
Chip Skull doesn't mind.
Chip Skull is awesome.
He is a little backwards.
Chip Skull. There we go.
Little goblin buddy.
Oh, it's so pretty. Thank you.
Oh, okay.
It'll be better painted, but I just got her like 2 or 3 days ago. My name's Lisa, and I play a wood elf druid named Melisande Falco. This is her. She loves nature and loves the earth, but does not like spiders.
She loves stabbing, too.
Killing me. When necessary.
Hey. There's our dice master friends. We're going to speak very loudly so that the camera will pick up.
No problem. Okay. Affirmative.
I am Brandon Z, Dungeon Master for Heroes of Awesome, and also
Dungeon Master Extraordinaire.
Oh, that's true. Yes. That is a fact. Proven.
Proven.
And I also hang out with these guys, the Twilight Chorus Band. Now, when we last left off,
what?
It's supposed to be like that.
They couldn't see it.
That was good. We were in an underground area. We had survived a weird rave with mushroom people.
Awesome.
We had fought a disgusting blob with many teeth and many eyes.
Many eyes that got punctured and exploded.
Yeah, it was pretty gross.
You're still covered in, right?
Yes, I am.
Yeah.
I believe Nebo's also covered.
No, remember, I wiped my face.
He specifically said, I cleaned myself up.
I just put a robe over my grossness.
And
we slayed some guards.
Slayed a couple guards.
Like Jim and Bob or something. The six gold an hour guard.
I think it was Bill and Bob or something like that. Two B names. And then we opened a door. What did we see when we opened the door?
It was a feast. Crazy orgy. Oh.
Different door.
Different door.
That was my other name. We walked in on
Handel at the head of the table,
inviting us in.
Welcome, friends.
Yeah.
Handel, as far as we know, is the leader of a cult that's trying to summon a green dragon that will kill Earth or world that we're in.
Sour venom.
It's like a terrorist.
Yeah, okay, gotcha.
A D&D terrorist. Yeah. This is like Osama bin Laden.
But somebody's inviting us to dinner.
All right. So before you, you see an incredible spread of food. Everything you've ever desired to eat is seemingly on this table. There's hams, there's turkeys, there's
IPA. Vegetables.
There are plenty of vegetables.
Yeah, yeah.
Delicious roots and berries. Perfectly prepared by a genius chef. And you have seven people around the table. Three on one side, three on the other. Handle down on the end, who just invited you to sit down. There are five chairs for you all. Sorry, there's not one for Chip's skull.
No, we can sit on my shoulder.
And,
okay, so we have to be in the field.
They're all wearing these peculiar robes that
I also happen to be wearing.
Do you have it on? You
did I put said it on. I did put it on.
Okay, so you were wearing it. It's just coated in muck and gross.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so what do you do?
So we were in here, right?
Yeah, we're not really going to use this so much because this will mostly be conversation. It can devolve into battle, but at that point we can react.
So any reason you gentlemen didn't do this upstairs in your house?
Well, this is where we really meet. This is, you know, a special group.
Were you expecting us?
I wouldn't say I was expecting you, but I mean, you did, you know, track me down in my hometown. Once we got that far, I was pretty sure that we would meet again.
Okay.
See, but a moment ago, you slammed the door in our face, a door that was trapped with explosives, and now you want to be our friend, as far as I can tell?
Well, I mean, the trap wasn't necessarily set for you, it was just set. And I'm going to have to talk to the guys that installed that. That really didn't pan out very well, obviously.
What about the running from us constantly?
I mean, so you understand that I'm fearing for my life, right? When I've got a big group of scary people coming to track me down.
So instead you go ahead and prepare them a feast?
Well, the feast is for us, but I hope you join us for it.
You happen to have the exact five chairs?
It's just coincidence. Mere coincidence.
So what's your gamble? What's your angle?
Well, maybe you'd consider joining our special group.
Your cult of sour venom?
You know, we're not solely dedicated to sour venom. You know, we have other interests.
Like what?
Well, there are other dragons. Maybe
here's one.
That he is certainly, you know, someone who he's an inn. He'll get us where we need to be.
and where is it you need to be?
Well, we want to be the lords and masters of the world, so that's pretty reasonable, right?
So world domination is your game.
Domination's such a harsh word. Domination like implies that we're. Yeah, that's basically it.
So, and just because we happen to find you, now we're in on your world domination, just like that?
Well, you're clearly powerful. You've tested yourselves against, you know, my terrible... Oh, you found our pet. I guess that would make sense. Yeah, okay. Well, if you survived that, then of course you should join us.
I should tell you, your pet's dead.
Oh.
He tried to kill us.
Well, I mean...
And your gods, we had to... Their throats.
See, you guys are perfect for our club. Bloodletting, joyless murderers. Come on.
But we were doing it for the greater good, you see.
We are too.
Oh, so how is a giant acid-spewing dragon for the greater good?
Well, it'll wipe out the unclean ones, and then we can rule the world and make it a better place.
And we were part of the unclean ones until we stumbled across this room.
I'm not going to say no to that, but you've tested your worth, and you've passed. Welcome, brothers and sisters.
See, I don't know about you guys, but...
I'm thirsty. Sounds good.
Yeah. Well, it does take us 4 hours to rest.
14?
Call the end.
Is there anywhere where I can go clean up?
Yeah, I mean, there's a basin in the next room. That's fine.
I'm going to go clean up.
Okay.
Yeah.
Make yourself presentable?
Yeah.
What do you think, Chippy?
I'm in. I mean, come on. These guys are jerks, right? We're not really going to do this.
Talk about it right now. I don't know if you heard me say that, but I want explicitly whisper.
You are not known for quiet.
Yeah.
Neither of you.
No.
Yeah, your whisper is still like twice my speaking.
I mean, that food looks great.
It does look pretty good. I don't remember the last time we ate.
I don't think we have in the entire campaign.
Which has been, what, a day?
We've had, like, alcohol, I think.
No, you guys rested and ate and drank at...
Federico Glico's house.
Federico Glico's house.
Yeah. Good point.
I don't think we should eat or drink without them doing it first.
So you're in a small room.
I'm in a small room.
It's got, like, you know...
So can I walk
basically
up?
A basin and water you can clean yourself with.
Clean myself? Is there anything else in the room?
No, there's no, like, exits or windows or anything like that.
Okay. Six gold pieces. Okay, I guess I'm now clean.
Are you going to rejoin everyone?
I'm going to rejoin everyone.
All right.
Can I walk up to one of the people and make them drink what they're drinking so that I can drink it?
I mean, they've been sipping their wine and beers and ales and waters.
So once I notice someone sips their drink, I'm going to go take it from them.
You take their drink from them? Okay, so let me explain the people a little bit. There's Handel, who you met, obviously. There is... I'm just going around the table, so if you need to know their position. Also, if you don't have paper for notes, you're going to need paper for notes and a pencil.
Is this going to be like L.A. Noir, or are we going to have to take, like...
You might want to take notes. I meant to warn you at the beginning, but I forgot. So, there is a thin man. He's very slight.
Christian Glover.
I'd say he looks a little bit like Crispin Glover in this movie, yes. Kind of peculiar looking, kind of weedy. There is a buxom woman with long flowing red hair. What's that?
Where are the locations?
So I'm going around from basically this part of the table.
Around. So Sandman.
And Handel's here.
Handel would be where Paul is at for me.
So is the other way? So if
we all have to draw it separately because we can't look at
each
other.
Oh, okay.
Curvy, very attractive.
I don't
very
know
beautiful.
What that means. So clearly, all right, busty lady.
There you go. You have a man and. A slightly older man with white peppery black hair, whiskers kind of done up in a fanciful beard. Philip Lipman. Let's see here. You have, on the far end, you have Handel. Next to him is a little girl. She's very young.
Oh, I don't like that. Is that shield? Creepy doll there. I hate it when there's little creepy girls.
I'm so sorry, though.
Jared from Subway or whatever.
Very appropriate. I would wait for that one.
Was that proven? I didn't look at the news at all today.
He pleaded guilty.
Oh,
awful.
Sorry.
They haven't got the other.
We'll move on.
Yeah, sorry.
Next is a large, burly, very muscly... man, his skin has like, you know, marks and burn marks. He's bald, but he does have a thick mustache. And the last fellow is a portly man who has jowls upon jowls, and when you look at his hands, he's bedecked in as many fanciful, expensive-looking rings and jewelry as you can squeeze onto his fat fingers. Snassages.
Are you listening?
Yeah.
He's got a lot of jewels.
I know. I got you.
So, the person you saw take a drink was the portly man.
Okay.
He pretty much nonstop sipping from his wine. All
right, so kind of go up and take a drink from him.
Didn't face him. Didn't take his cat?
He's right next to the burly man.
It's all
right.
Okay, see. So
you
snag his cap, and he's like, hey, what is that? And he kind of pauses and looks at you, and I'll pour myself another.
Much obliged.
This is a glass, please. Reaches over and grabs a glass, and
where are all our seats then?
Fills it up with a bottle from
around the
table.
The end. Yeah.
All right, I guess I'm going to sit down. At this end table, farthest away.
You're at the other head of the table?
Yeah.
Alright.
So, I'll sit down next to the thin man.
I'll sit next to the little girl.
So you're going to squeeze in between some cultists? I mean some people?
The little girl's right there, right?
No, the girl's next to handle.
Oh, I did that backwards.
Yeah. This is correct, right? So they're all here. And then there's these.
Yeah.
Oh,
might be. So I will not sit next. I will sit next to the guy with the jewels.
Yeah, makes sense.
I sit next to the thin man.
I'm sitting next to, in between you two.
Oh, wow. I do have that right.
So I'm now here.
Okay, that only leaves one spot there.
This
Rizzo.
Is.
Or you could just chill in the back.
You don't have to sit.
Is next to the whiskey dude?
Yeah, I'm standing by the door.
Linja.
Okay.
Rizzo,
Nebo,
me,
Einhorn. You pretty much have that exact opposite, but that's okay.
Oh, okay. So it just flipped.
Yeah.
Okay.
So he just goes through
you? How about this?
Yeah, that works. Nebo, Rizzo. Okay, yeah, I got it. So you're sipping on the wine?
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty good.
It is. It is actually, I mean, you don't know what wine is. You've never had it.
It's not making me throw up.
But it is. It tastes amazing to you. It is like...
Yes, but how do we know that our glasses aren't poisoned? You took one of your glasses.
We're not really in the habit of poisoning our guests, but...
But it's awfully convenient.
If you want to drink
you had
from...
everything ready to go. Before we could see you set it up.
Okay. Do you want me to get you like a fresh glass or something?
How about the portly gentleman here?
Hey! Harry! I'm big bone!
Mr. Bedazzle.
Handed over his drink. How about you all hand over your drinks to us and you take these chalices? I assume they were laid out for you.
They were. So the beautiful woman says, are we really doing this? Are we giving them our drink that we've been... Yeah?
I'd rather do that than be poisoned and die.
Okay, fine. Please, let's arrange for the glasses to be switched. And the weedy guy is kind of gross. Like...
It could be Rizal's that he's not
gonna drink it.
Yeah. So... There's a big glass switch.
It's a gesture of goodwill. If you're trying to convince us.
The little girl's like, it's like musical chairs, but stupid. She's not drinking wine. She's drinking water anyways.
I'll have hers.
There you go. Ah, look at that. So you grab their glasses, and they start pouring wine and drinks and the glasses that were laid out for you, and they're drinking them without hesitation. Eat!
So...
Sit down! Be merry!
While we're eating...
I'm sorry, do we gain any health or hit points back from eating or drinking or anything?
No.
Okay,
just curious. No.
Not yet.
Not a video game.
Alright, I'm like...
I find a ham in a wall.
That's right. I break a barrel, it goes...
What's that bridge from Lord of the Rings?
Like, oh, yes.
Oh, the Elven.
Yeah. The Elven bridge.
That's certainly a possibility, but not.
I like the Castlevania reference.
But it's not a wall. We didn't punch a wall.
Give me a minute.
Maybe you should have. You'd find healing ham.
Yeah. Wall chicken.
Turkey.
Well, I will eat.
So what are we eating?
Well, that's a good question. What are you eating?
I want to know what's here.
I mean, there's so many delicious foods. Salads, any kind of roast beast you can imagine. Some you have not ever imagined.
Ah, my favorite, seaweed and meatloaf. Bring it.
Send out the beast.
All right, so there is actually another cloak where you can't see them. This person comes from the back and helps serve you. But you don't see any features or anything like that. Just a cloak.
A cloak that serves us?
Mm-hmm. A cloaked server.
Well, there's someone
like in it. Wearing the cloak. Yeah.
But yeah. It's very...
It's not Ghost of Christmas Past.
I wasn't sure. This is magic.
It's draped over them, so you can't make out any features. Or
who's with the cloak and the cloakresses?
which one of us? Oh, our servant? Yeah. Well, he's serving you food.
Why can't I see him?
I mean, he's unimportant.
I believe that. Just curious, why?
Well, I don't want to look at our servants while we're enjoying meal with our equals.
Oh, okay, my bad. Interesting.
So you haven't convinced me to join you yet. What benefits do we gain from joining your merry little band?
Well, when the Great Reckoning comes, you will not be burned, and you may survive and profit greatly.
Did you say may survive?
Well, I mean, there are those of us that are weak of constitution that may not survive the end times, or those that would potentially betray the trust and order of our organization, and they'll also die.
So, this little girl you have here, for instance, is she of strong enough constitution to survive a dragon?
She's like, I'm the strongest of all of us! Candle's like, that's kind of true.
Can this I get an introduction to the rest of
you can. You'd like to know our names.
Yes, I do.
We'd be happy to share our names if you would share yours with us.
Which were written in advance so we don't get wastefully
happy. I'm ready.
This time.
No Federico Obligo this time. Favorite.
So, Handel, we know you.
Yes, I am Handel.
Who named you?
My mother?
After what?
What?
After what? A doorknob?
No, it's spelled
easy on host for now.
D-E-L.
Okay.
Illiterate bastard. Who are you?
Oh, me. You can call me Linja. Okay,
Linja. It's a fascinating name. Who named you? And you are, sir?
I am Einhorn. You may have heard of me.
I have.
Oh, well, excellent.
Word of your musical exploits has traveled even to our little town.
Well, you were at the festival, dressed as a jester for some reason.
I don't remember you playing. I do. You guys were terrible. It was awesome. So good. I will never forget that performance ever again.
That's exactly what I aimed for.
Sounds fishy about that.
Who's your fellow horned friend?
Keep going.
All right. Strong silent tech.
Mabo.
Oh, so the
and who's your little guy?
I'm Chip Skull.
If it's just the two, that's just two energy.
Goblin Lotharia.
Wait a minute, Chip Skull. Do you know any of these?
Nope. Right. Never met these guys.
I mean, I saw that dude before, right?
No,
you didn't. I didn't see him. I don't know.
I don't know. I'm asking you, Chip Skull.
Well, he was with us when we were walking to the mansion.
Yeah. Well,
I guess he saw him in front of the bar.
Yeah, so he's seen Handel. Yeah.
We walked together. Carried Handel to the...
But, I mean, at least I had suspected he was working with them because he was, like, guarding their passageway. So that's why I asked.
Are we not going to talk about the fact that he said that his skills have reached them even here? That's suspicious.
No, it is.
What's that? What are we not talking about?
He's buttering you up.
Yeah,
why?
He was the jester at the... He saw us before.
He seemed
trying to stoke my ego, but I...
Anyways, let's continue. I want to meet our guests.
And you are?
I'm Mel.
Mel.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well, Mel. All right, so the weedy guy who looks constantly nervous. So my name is Reed. That's all you need to know. The buxom lady says, I am Satalia. A pleasure.
Satalia?
Satalia. The gentleman with the salt and pepper hair and the pointy beard. I am Parthel. A pleasure. Welcome. The little girl says, I'm Vandis. I'm 8 years old.
These are all humans, right?
They're all human. Okay. Yes, they're all human. That was awesome. The big guy says, Dubel. That's it. And the bigger fella says, I'm Horfrin. I am
a
wonderful person. I am so excited to be a part of this club. I hope you'll join this too. I mean, it's, the opportunities are wonderful. You'll never get tired of being a part of us. I mean, I want you to know that this is going to be an excellent, excellent use of your time.
Judging from your jewels, I assume you're bankrolling this operation?
Oh, no, no, no. No, that would be all hand up.
I can't really do anything.
So, Handel, are you the leader then?
Leader. There's such a complicated word. We're a group. We're a trust. We believe in each other's abilities, and we count on each other.
And what are those abilities?
Well,
please enumerate them and hand them.
I mean, what are your many abilities? You guys seem very talented in unusual ways.
So I use awakened mind and look directly at each one of my comrades and say, I do not trust anything these people have to offer.
Okay. So they all think that?
Wait, Mars, were you telepathically telling us you don't trust them? Mm-hmm. Okay.
And they can send messages back. Yeah.
Word.
Oh, okay. It's like, I totally agree, but I want to find out how they're going to summon this dragon and how to stop it while they're being friendly.
How are we going to do that?
Ask. If we're going to be part of this, can I talk to him through his
mind? It's more of a...
Tell.
Walkie-talkie time. Walkie-talkie time.
Tell Einhorn.
How? As to you...
Stop. What am I sending in?
Ask Einhorn. What's his game plan here?
Yeah, he's figuring stuff out.
Goldie
man.
Wants to know what your plan is.
Goldie.
If they want us to be part of their group, they're gonna tell us how it works. And if not, then we kill them.
Forward.
All right, your point, man.
This is fine. It's like a telegram.
Yeah.
Not sure. Stop. Need help.
You're at point.
Okay. So.
But did we understand any of that?
So I mean, you guys mostly, whatever you heard his conversation, then I don't trust them.
Oh, okay.
Do you guys want to say anything to him?
I mean, I would say the same thing that he said, which is, I mean, I don't trust them either.
Doesn't mean we can't enjoy this feast.
Yeah, I would say let's kind of just question them.
I'd like to know more about the gentleman to my left.
You've all gone strangely quiet all of a sudden.
The food's just so good. We haven't eaten in a long time. It's just a meal of this quality.
Please, dig in. Eat.
You guys have entertainment? Music?
I'm sure we can muster some up. I don't know if it's, you know, on par with your usual
light.
How do you entertain an entertainer, you know?
Not up for the challenge.
I would volunteer, but I'm
no, we're meeting. Enjoying it.
All right, so, handle like, all right. And you hear, like, a beautiful stringed instrument emanating into the room.
Nice.
You don't see the player.
So what was the holdup? All you had to do was snap your finger.
The holdup for what?
Why is it?
Never mind.
Well, I mean, you all are so very talented. I wouldn't want to shame our in-house musicians.
Sounds very nice.
So you say we have the talents and abilities to join your group, So what exactly does your group do involved with this dragon?
Well, I mean, you saw us trying to, you know, summon him at the festival.
And we didn't see you do anything.
Well, that's because our, you know, our situation was interrupted by a band of musicians.
Well, you did murder a man playing the king in broad daylight.
That was a big part of that, you know, summoning a dragon.
So you have to murder an innocent man in broad daylight?
Well, you know, it was kind of, that's more of a token.
What's that?
It's more, I keep knocking over my phone. That's more of a token, you know, offering for Sour Venom. There's more complicated rites, but we didn't really get to attend to those.
I would love to hear about the rites.
I mean, we're sharing a lot of trade secrets here. Maybe we could just eat some dinner first and enjoy and make small talk. In fact, we even have a game for you.
I'm playing D&D.
Getting better here.
We have a game to play. It's a little dinner game. And, you know, fabulous prizes.
I can't keep this my next turn.
Yeah.
I
like
prizes. I can keep it through their turn.
So, we have a proposition. You know our names. We'd like you, by the end of this dinner, to tell us our jobs. We'd also like you to tell us what is our driving motivation. Should you win, we will tell you anything you want to know about our little club.
Everyone's? We need to know everyone's?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
All right. That's the game. So small talk. So what do you do?
So what's your job and what's your motivation?
It won't be that easy, friends. We're not complete dullards. Most of us aren't complete dullards. But,
maybe we should, take a walk.
I'm afraid that would spoil the game.
Break up into groups and get to know each other.
Let's all sit at the table. We're eating.
I can walk and talk and eat.
Just grab your plate.
We're good to go.
I mean, you may have noticed that if you walk and talk and eat here, you'll probably end up eaten by something.
Well, we did kill most everything out in the cage, but...
Is that what you think? Okay. Well, in that case, feel free to leave.
Oh, no, I'm...
Best of luck. Sit around. Chat with us.
So what are the rules? Do we just ask you questions? Or?
Well, you can ask us questions, but if you ask three questions that we refuse to answer, the game is over.
What if you just refuse all three and then that's it?
We'll keep it fair, you know. Don't ask us what our jobs are. Don't ask us what our motivation is, and we will do our best to answer your questions as cleverly as possible.
Okay.
All right, young girl.
So we're not even going
to... Vendis?
Valis?
Oh, yeah.
Vendis. Is it Vendis? I got Valis.
Vendis.
Well, maybe.
It was worth it.
With no planning. What does your typical day look like?
Oh, I wake up. I play with my dolls. I go outside and I spy on the neighbor boy. I hate the neighbor boy. I really hate the neighbor boy. I just want to like take his face. I want to. That's enough, Vanis. Please.
I had a neighbor like that once.
How long did that neighbor last?
Not very long.
So what do you hate about this neighbor boy?
Oh, I just don't like his face. I don't like the way he talks. I don't like the way he says my name. I'm gonna take him apart. I'm gonna throw him away. I'm gonna feed him to my pet. It's gonna be great. I'm just gonna feel so good about destroying. Okay, Vandis. That's enough of an answer.
What kind of pet do you have?
Oh, I have a pet doggy. His name is Mr. Barks. But when Mr. Barks is bad, I kick him.
Dog kicker.
Only when he's bad, so he better be a good dog.
You don't kiss babies either.
Babies? I hate babies.
Are you an only child?
Why do I have to answer all the questions? I'm done answering questions. You're so stupid. God, I hate this golden guy. Maybe I'll just tear him apart.
I don't like tiny humans.
You think you can tear apart
this? You're a jerk.
How do you think you can tear apart
this? I hate him.
He's so much bigger than you.
Well, he's stupid. I will get him.
Let's let Vanda's cool
she
down.
She grabs a potato.
She grabs a potato.
And throws him at his face.
What if she meant to?
We're going to make a dexterity roll on that. All
right, so.
Oh, you rolled the wrong die.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
You should roll the wrong side.
That was a bad roll anyhow, so I get that one out of the system.
11
plus 2, 13.
All right, so you catch most of it in your hand, but there are flecks of potato that hit poor Nebo in the face and upper area. She laughs. You guys are both stupid.
I eat the potato.
What would be the appropriate response? Yeah, Norns, to a tiny human special.
Just a child.
Right, just ignore her.
Just we'll talk to someone else. Mm-hmm. Often when you ignore children,
you can't ignore me. I'm the smartest and best and strongest.
Who said that? Anyhow, let's,
you guys are idiots. I said it, dummy. You and your one dumb horn.
Weird echo, overpowering the loot or whatever.
Oh. I see what he's doing. Tell him to stop. He's a jerk. I hate that guy. I should kill him. Hey.
Well, at least let me finish the game before you kill me.
Is that the plan? Oh.
So, poor friend, where did you get all your tools?
I have lots of money. I have various weaknesses. One of them is making myself look as fine as possible. I'm an attractive man, and I want you to know that I also have a lot of wealth. So I wear it around me, and it's very fetching, wouldn't you agree?
Would you say you're a collector?
Oh, I collect many things. I collect jewelry, I collect clothing, I collect dolls. I mean, I don't really collect dolls. I just have some.
So,
Vendis, have you seen his dolls?
No. I don't like him very much. He's pretty gross.
But you don't hate his face.
I kind of do. Oh, okay. It's really gross. And hey, it's not very nice. I really hate him a lot.
Is there anyone you like? Other than your dog.
I like my mommy.
Who's your mommy?
Oh, that would be telling.
Did she just refuse a question?
She did refuse a question.
Oh,
might
be. Family Feud X?
Question mark.
It takes no damage from higher level.
All right. Interesting. Well, we'll leave that be then, mm-hmm. I guess.
Mm-hmm. All right, so you like to collect jewels, money, and dolls. What else do you like?
Oh, I like everything. I want to have it all. It's, you know, the warm sunshine, I can't get enough. Cool air nights, I can't get enough. I just love it all. Food is delicious. I'll drink it all. It's the best.
Okay. Is there something you're in search of? Other than, you know, everything.
Everything.
Is there one holy grail that you haven't found yet?
Holy grail. I'd be after a holy grail. That sounds wonderful. I'd like 8 holy grails. I'd like 20 holy grails. I want them all.
Mm-hmm.
Every question I'm thinking of, I feel like I'm getting it refused now.
So. Now you're proceeding with caution.
Yeah. And just throw out random shit and just be like...
So, alright. What about Dubell? Where'd you get all your scars from?
It has to be a fist card. From my work.
Careful. Do you work with humans?
I work for humans.
Cool. Does your work keep you in shape?
I'd say it keeps me pretty, pretty strong.
Or I can play Hero Brick.
Ever have any difficulties with your work?
Well, my work is hard. It's not sitting around and counting money, and it's not making fancy dinners or anything like that. I spend a lot of effort, manpower, doing my work. But I'm done talking. Leave me alone.
Fair enough.
Sits down there, closes his eyes.
Oh, I thought he goes to cover, right? I thought.
Oh, yeah, you're right. I'm sorry. Knockout, yeah.
Busty lady. Bust. Are those real?
Busty.
I have a name, honey.
Satalia.
Did you ask me if they're real? They're as real and as fine as you will ever see.
Not the only one.
Play your cards, right? You'll see them.
Not my thing, but maybe these guys.
A little bit weird, but.
What drew you to this crowd? What drew you to this crowd?
I'm sorry, what's what?
What drew you?
What drew me to this? Well, you know, I'm of local note, and I'm not far from here, actually. I saw them secretly gathering, so I kind of sent my own folks to find out what's going on. They never came back, so I came in myself. And I was welcomed in. Turns out if you have enough pool in a community, you can be a part of things that you normally would not be able to.
Did you have to walk through the pet that we had to walk through?
Oh no, we have another entrance. We don't have to ever face that thing.
Right. Did we have a name for the pet?
I don't have a name for it. I think it's a disgusting, horrible monster.
Okay.
Well, then you won't miss it.
I don't at all. There are others, though.
Is there anyone you like in particular?
No. I like people.
You like people?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if she's ready to get schooled.
Do you like Vindus over here?
Turn into a
Do you like Vindus over here?
No.
Yeah. I have a special bond with that little brat.
Vindus, do you like this pretty lady?
Of course I do.
Have that part of
home. Oh, man.
Satalia, do you have any kids?
Well, I suppose I do.
How many?
Just one.
How? That's what I figured. All right, I'll leave it at that. I don't want to get refused.
So, three.
What?
You seem very jumpy. Something putting you ill at ease?
Hey, are you gonna eat that steak? Shoves his fork of the steak in your plate and starts eating it.
I was eating meatloaf, but okay.
Meatloaf it is! what was that?
I said you seem a little jumpy around us. Are you alright?
Oh, no, I'm fine. I'm good. I'm done with that. I want that.
It's just a root.
The root's good. Nah, it's not really that good. That was
can
it
I
all.
Have it
no.
So, how do you
root?
Stay so thin?
You can grab that.
What's your secret?
I work out a lot. I mean, I'm up and down and kind of all over the place. You know, I go places, move around a lot.
Also grab that.
Where are you from?
Who are you asking?
Reed.
Second string.
I'm from I'm from this town.
Happy Hearth.
Yeah. I lived here for all my life. He's eyeballing your loot. I bet I can play that pretty good.
Reed is
looking at his loot.
Oh, you mean Elisa?
Oh, she has a name? Oh, yeah, give me that. Cool. Sweet. I'm not so good at that. No, give that back. That's cool.
I mean, you said give it back. I took it. I didn't give it back to him again.
I got you. It's like, well, I mean, you can... Can I have that back? Can I have that back?
No, I think you've just demonstrated your level of ability.
Oh, yeah, well...
I would guess that's not your job.
No.
How about you, Parthel? Fan of music?
No. I mean, everyone's a fan of music, right? But not that. And from what I hear of yours, not yours either.
Hey.
Straight to the point, I like you.
pretty sweet beard.
Thank you. I got meticulously sculpted every day.
How long have you been growing it?
Oh, I mean, I've always had a beard. I keep it perfectly trimmed.
Yeah, I've just been following what the...
Sounds like it's really important to you.
It's as important to me as, his horn. Mm-hmm. His horns. And his... I guess that scales all over that guy.
Mm-hmm. Say it,
his little goblin buddy.
So it defines you?
No, it just looks good. I'm a gentleman. I want to look good.
No, that's Mr. Gold.
Very important, and people need to know that I have a certain style.
Are you married?
I'm not.
So if you were to show up at your work not looking important as you should, would there be any ramifications?
I could get away with it. It wouldn't have to be perfectly, but it's a pride thing. I want to look good, I want to feel good, and, I want to know that my work is appreciated for what it is, but sometimes I have to make some FaceTime.
TV star. Just kidding.
You might want to sit down for this.
It's professional wrestler.
Mm-hmm.
So did the word bay come from people YouTube trying to type out bay in the streamer D?
Huh? You don't want to speak, Joe? What are the blacks?
He's concocting a plan here.
Candle, how are we doing so far?
You're not attacking?
Uh-oh. What's happening?
How many hit points do you lose for?
Roll your perception.
I like that you're like, roll it.
Yeah.
Oh, you didn't bring your sheet?
I know, I was seeing my perception.
A one?
Why do I keep rolling ones?
Don't you have inspiration? You have inspiration.
No, it's too late to roll that.
You have to
roll together.
It's okay.
What's everyone else's passive perception?
Oh.
My perception is zero.
Well,
okay.
Perception?
Where's passive perception?
Passive wisdom.
There should be.
Oh, mine is 15.
That for 11. Somewhere.
Oh, here, 15.
You didn't fill it.
15? 15?
Probably 15.
Mine's 11.
So it's going to be...
Probably 15.
She's just like, I'm going to go up to the top.
No, probably. Is it definitely 15?
I'm my boy here.
I can go look. Where would it be?
Well, do you have proficiency in the perception?
I don't.
Okay, then it's probably not 15.
Mine's 11, and I have no extra bonus.
Do you have any bonus in wisdom?
One.
Okay, so then your passive perception is 11.
Okay, got it.
Probably 15.
Okay, and you two are next... to each other on the table,
mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All right. So you
it's
both
me, Lisa, and James.
You both kind
of spot it. You're sitting next
None
to
None of
her,
you know so. This, but
you sat next to the
Yeah. Rizal sat right there?
Yeah. And then
Satalia is totally checking out your buddy Rizal. You're giving him the look.
Like the look or the look?
Kind of look.
Like a she wants to flash him type of look?
That would be a very PG-13 way to say that.
Yes. That,
it happens a lot. I mean,
there's a certain princeliness about him that...
It's the horns.
Probably heard you're a prince.
So...
And I heard you're a soldier.
I'm going to...
So the busty woman looks at him lustfully?
You don't see nothing.
Oh, I don't see nothing. Sorry.
You're sitting next to him. Just give him a little nudge. Let him know where...
Not so good
at whispering.
Yeah, I can't see
you. Well, write him a note then.
Hey, what are you guys talking about?
Hey!
That's a loud note.
Yeah.
This is good wine.
Yes. Carthel says, I picked it myself.
Good taste. Thank I've never you. Had it before, but it's fabulous.
Well, I mean, really, I feel it complements the meal quite a bit. Even though the meal consists of everything, it's a very general, wonderful, palatable wine.
Could you go tell Rizal for me that he really needs to at least smell this wine? It's very good. Can you go tell him that?
He's sitting next to you.
Is he your friend right next to you?
No, he's in the back of the room.
Yes.
Is he at the back of the room? I thought he was at the table.
That's Einhorn.
He's right next to you.
No, Einhorn's next to him.
No, I was standing at the back.
He's standing at the back.
Oh, you're standing at the back. Okay.
Can you tell him?
Sure. Well, he's not sitting there, so nobody's sitting next to
him. Yeah, you're sitting next to the portly guy and nobody.
But I'm close.
But the you're jewels, close. You're like, jewels.
Yeah. Hey, Rizal. I'm passing on a message that
roll a D20.
The wine is really good.
I'm
going to
get knocked
out. I have
no idea what you're talking about.
Six plus anything? There's a lady.
Plus your wisdom.
At 5 o'clock, checking out.
So you got a seven.
Seven?
Yeah.
Ooh. That happens.
Nothing happens?
I'm going to make...
What were you rolling for? I don't know.
question mark.
Oh, wait, no, I'm not. I couldn't do it.
So I have a question for all of you. Without revealing any of your jobs, do they all relate to each other? Are there no overlaps? Each job unique? Like, you all have a purpose on this council?
We all have our own unique jobs, right? Right? Yeah. We don't all do this. None of us do the same thing.
And did that factor into you becoming part of this cult, or was that incidental?
Happy coincidence, I think.
Come on, sidekick.
Is there anyone else like you in this organization?
This is most of the organization right here, besides some servants. This is the upper crust, if you will.
So, if we were to become a part of this organization, where would we fall within this hierarchy?
Really?
Well, we would hope to groom you to be at our table. At first, you might have to work your way up, but... you're all very talented. We see that as a strong possibility.
What work is involved?
Well, I mean, we might utilize your talents for seeking out other recruits or for, you know, summoning demons.
Maybe. But is there a concern that our abilities might, let's say, step on the toes of your responsibilities individually or collaboratively?
Oh, no. Well spoken, dragon friend. First of all, but we would, no, I mean, we hope to bring you up to our level. You know, as our, you know, trusted lieutenants, we're sure that you would do your job very well and effectively. And we could count on you to do what needs to be done.
So say in our workings with you, we came across a magic item. Which one of you would we bring that to?
That's a good question. We'll find out.
Right?
No matter who I walk.
I think I got an iPad on lock password, yeah.
I have an answer for that. Oh, Horfin says, oh, it'd be me, of course. Well, I deal in many things. It would be of great interest to the community, to travelers. I would be the one. And then Reed goes, no. I would be the guy. You take it to me, and I could get you the most for it.
Well, I'm trying, I wonder, because you said that's game no matter what, so I could handle, yeah, what would you say, what would I say about that, would you take yours to Reed or Hoffman? I mean, I trust my friends very much, but I would keep it myself.
Interesting. I'm the only one who would really know what to do with that. I mean, I can handle it. And they all start to look at him like, I'm the only one who would really know the true value and purpose of such an item.
You know, people look at him like in agreement with him or kind of like...
kind of scoffing a little.
Scoffing a little, like, yeah. They don't...
Yep.
Okay, so, cool. How do you all feel about each other?
Yeah, you had this guy back.
Well, I think for the most part we're friends, right? Right. Vanda's like,
thank you for teaching me.
No.
Beginner's luck all the way.
Besides Vanda's.
It's like, so Reed says like, well, I trust them and I like them, but I mean, I feel like this is unfair. They have so much more than me, and I'm the low man on the totem pole. I don't really appreciate that.
Wait, sorry, who's saying this? Reed.
It's like, I'm going to be higher up. I'm tired of being stamped on by some of them. I mean, they're nice, and they've taken me in, so I can't complain too much, but I want what they have.
Parthol, you are okay with the fact that Wrath is so much better?
It is like Warriors in many ways, but it's like Warriors where you get to decide what your field is instead of having a random one. Have you played Warriors?
Yeah, I know that they made it.
So what was your question again?
I'm asking Parthol if he's alright.
It was like a deck building game, but like this, it was dice, so you had to purchase stuff. Yeah.
Parthol is what?
I'm asking Parthol if he's alright with the fact that handles so much better.
Purchased dice. And then kind of took them from other players. Like
you mean better looking? I wouldn't say that.
Yeah.
Just you mean better in general? More commanding.
Better. I don't see that as a thing. I think. I mean, he kind of put us all together, but we're all on equal terms.
So outside of this cult meeting room, which is great, by the way, would you ever run into each other doing your jobs?
Some of us would. Some of us wouldn't.
Fairly similar.
Some of us have actually employed the others as far as like our day-to-day jobs. We move about in silence.
So you're saying never at any point is there conflict?
Professional conflict?
Yeah.
Well,
I don't know that there's ever been professional conflict. What's his name? Horfin?
Horfin.
I didn't name him.
Butterball.
I don't think it would be Dazzle.
Horfin. Horfin says, well, I've run against one of our own. We've had some problems in the past, but I believe we've worked them out as we've become members of this secret club.
Satalia
says, like, I've run across a couple of them a couple of times.
Yeah, I mean, this guy.
We know what you mean, girl.
Like, I saw him and I was like, well,
my boyfriend said,
I noticed the six and I was like, well. But yeah, there's some good
looking ones in there. You could. No? Mind if I?
Yeah.
Yes.
You do mind.
No, you had a good strategy. I didn't catch any of that.
Yeah, I'm not catching all of
it. I'm not catching all of it.
I've caught enough.
I know there's something.
Did she hit you?
No.
Not on me.
No.
Oh, I'm sorry, we can't. This is table talk.
Well, I'm right next to you. Why can't I hear this?
Right,
I've got great hearing.
Okay. What I was asking.
But you can't hear it.
When Horfin said that he ran against someone and it's been resolved, I'm saying, did I perceive any facial expression on anyone, like, anyone kind of like, or... Like,
roll an insight check.
Don't use my dice.
12 plus nothing, I guess.
Oh, yes, you do. That's a 1. So, Reed goes... Clears his throat.
It's clear.
Let's go.
And how about people like us? Would we have run into you outside of...
You're saying that to who?
Just the table in general.
Many of you would come across us in your day-to-day experiences here in Happy Hearth.
Are you guys all from Happy Hearth?
Well, we all live here. We're not all from here, necessarily.
Ever heard of a man called Frederico Obligo?
Yeah, he's pretty much the man to be in this town, for now.
That doesn't bother you, Reed?
Reed says, yeah, I've heard of Frederico Obligo. I've been to his place before.
Were you invited?
I'm still in some of your dice.
I mean, no.
Are you standing outside of it?
No, for a little bit.
All right. What's up? What's up with we gotta talk about Satalia.
Are any of them?
She's eyeing everybody.
She didn't eye me. I'm disappointed.
Oh, she's eyeing you.
Oh, now she's eyeing me.
Okay. Everybody.
I didn't catch that part. I thought he was the only one, and you were the only one that got that. Mm-hmm.
You don't even have a
Does your job involve things that you'd like to do?
I think everything involves things I like to do. Everything in the world. So, yeah.
So what kind of things do you like to do?
Seems like...
Well, I can drink any of you under the table. I can do other things under the table.
Mm-hmm. Well, we have Chip Skull under there, don't we?
Yeah, he's down here. Chip Skull's very quiet.
Okay.
Handel, I have a question about your daughter.
What was that?
I have a question about your daughter, Handel.
How do you?
Has it been a problem that she's been, I don't know, and forgive me for this, she seems a little wrathful.
My daughter?
Your daughter.
My daughter? How do you know my daughter?
You don't want to learn how to put earbuds, do
you? No. Not at all.
How about your daughter, Satalia?
She's a handful.
Mm-hmm. She like dolls?
I believe so.
Mm-hmm. It must be hard growing up.
So the cards
under such a beautiful
one card to die ratio.
Wait, human.
What? I was like, where did that question end? Must be hard growing up under a beautiful human.
Mendes.
And then the packs that you get has one.
Danis was Handel's daughter.
No.
We were
I know that's what you were going for. It's not
Italian, but we haven't confirmed that. We can't really ask.
So you're asking Vandis?
That must have been difficult.
Yeah. My mom is beautiful.
Yeah. Must be difficult.
I wouldn't think so. I think my mom's the most beautiful woman in the world.
Same. I can live up to that.
What do you mean live up to that? Hey, I don't like this guy's. What he's saying.
She still has more potatoes on her plate. Yeah, exactly.
Hey, get him out of here. I'm going to go hit him.
That's fine. I'll go talk to my friend.
I think what he means is that what if other men come and try to steal your mother away from you?
Oh, they don't do that.
They don't do that?
I mean, they can try. They don't come back ever again.
Ooh. Do you stop them?
Then? If I have to.
What's that?
But she can handle herself, right?
Who, my mom?
Yeah.
I mean, she can protect herself for sure, but... Sometimes I get angry. And sometimes they don't go back home to their families. Now, so if you're hanging in the back of the room, there's no more talking.
I can't talk to him?
He's in the back of the room, apparently.
That's where I went.
He said he's going to get up and go.
Oh, I didn't hear that.
Because Vindas was going to throw more things at him.
No, okay. I couldn't catch it.
He walked over to talk to him, and then now he's asking him to transmit a message to all of us.
Okay. We feel like you all should sit down at the table to play this game.
Okay.
What do you mean? You don't seem to be playing fairly right now.
You guys feel that way, or we feel that way?
They don't.
Oh, okay.
They feel that way. Handel says that.
Okay. I'll come back.
Reluctantly, I come back. And find a spot at the table.
Welcome. Guy we don't know.
His name is Rizal.
A pleasure to meet you, Rizal. You seem of your, a finer stock than maybe your friends.
This is just a regular bag. Oh, you have regular dudes.
Cool. All right.
So Parthel finished his plate and starts heaping out onto another one. He's like really impressed with the flavor of the food and the quality of it. And he's enjoying more, enjoying some drinks. Horfin, also enjoying a bunch of food. Our big burly tough man friend has started snoring a bit.
397, what is that?
Satalia is giving you the look.
The little side of the
7-4. Randomizer. Cute.
Satalia, I think you need to go excuse yourself. Took care of some business.
Get yourself a room.
Yeah.
Probably right, but we have work to do here.
And I'm not doing that kind of work here. It's not my job.
Low key.
Is it a job with you? Oh, see, that's a pleasure to me.
See, it's pretty high strung for a guy named Loki. Mm.
Do you have daddy issues to tell you?
No, oh. I don't think so.
Is that Omega Red?
Rich, powerful woman like me? I wouldn't think so.
That's pretty.
Maybe it's KG Beast.
I'm
impressed you guys are still only at one question that they didn't answer.
Is this 20 and 30?
Been cautious.
So we're.
But I'm thinking of a question.
What's in the Justice League starter?
To push it a bit further, because we can afford another X.
The next one's coming up.
Is it an X per person?
No. Oh, no.
Three X's and it's over.
This is silly. You should play.
I feel like any question I'm thinking of now is
the burly guy still has his eyes closed.
Yeah, he's snoring.
Sorry, like the muscle guy.
Yeah,
the muscle guy. The fat guy is snoring.
Oh, no, he said
the muscly dude is snoring.
Yeah. I thought you said Horfin was.
Horfin was also getting more food.
He's eating more food, and so is Parthel.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I thought multiple people were falling asleep on this.
No, just the burly dude.
Okay.
So Parthel.
Yeah.
You like sport?
As much as the next man?
Do you take part in any kind of, like, friendly fighting?
No, I'm quieter, stay at home, working man. I don't need to bare-knuckle brawl. Surely you do, though.
I do enjoy it.
I believe that. You look at...
What about you, Handel?
Handel? Oh, what are you asking him if he likes to fight? I wouldn't say that I'm much of a fighter. You've pretty much seen that, right? In a couple instances.
Yeah.
Outside of her, Yeah, no.
So the house we came through earlier, was it yours?
Yeah.
Are you guys not
Did you install the traps, or is that part of the cult?
Oh, we brought in a very technically minded person to do it.
Ooh, poetry.
No one here.
So I don't know the answer to that. Let's say what brought you to the festival, but obviously the Summon the Dragon, so.
That was the goal.
Yeah.
Was that the first summoning? Would that have been your first summoning?
That was our first attempt to summon Sour Venom.
Have you ever met Sour Venom?
No one has. Only rumors have existed about Sour Venom.
So what even got you on this idea?
Well, I mean, it seems like a viable, destructive force that we can not necessarily control, but maybe coerce into doing some favors for us. Sometimes you just have to appeal to a dragon's good sensibilities and coffers.
So who would be the one to speak?
Nobody doesn't want you there.
Oh, that would be me, absolutely. I mean, again, I trust my friends, but this is a very special task, and I might be the only person up for that.
And the rest of you, do you trust him with this task, convincing a dragon to spare your lives?
Reed says, I think I could talk to him, too. Handel gives him the look. He's like, maybe I can't.
It was pretty close, though.
We would trust him. They all kind of, most of them shake their head in agreement, besides the sleeping guy. Who stirs a little bit.
So you have no suspicion of him, I don't know, turning the dragon for himself, or... anything like that?
Can you see we pull out two guys?
Well, I think that one man. We'll say this is Horfin. We'll go change of voice.
Yeah.
One man could have controlled a dragon, but you know, that would be silly. And Handel says, I don't know. Maybe I could. I'm pretty practiced. I know some things about some things. I could do it.
So, Handel, if you were to lose your associates here, and you were forced to just be you, would it be a blow to your cult?
We'd lose most of our board. Of course, the cult would suffer, but I would continue in our, you know, our quest.
So, basically, what you're saying is they're expendable.
I am not saying that at all. That's a very different statement than what I would ever say. I'm just saying that they're not quite as crucial to the cause as I am. And they all sort of take exception to that. But they're not very vocal about it. Like, whispering and muttering.
So, Arthur, how does it feel to be not as needed as you thought?
I was pretty needed tonight, wasn't I?
What?
Well, I'm just saying that my services were required tonight.
When?
Tonight. Your friend is rather thick, isn't he?
I am, so explain it to me.
He is, so explain it to him.
Well, you're all here, we're here. I was needed for this to happen.
And if you hadn't been able to attend, then what would have happened?
Well, I guess it'd be a much less interesting dinner party. Probably wouldn't even be a dinner party.
You brought the food?
You brought the party.
I brought the thrust. Yeah, I'd say I brought the food. It's delicious, isn't it?
Yes, it is. It's excellent.
Do you hunt?
Best you've ever had.
Do you hunt?
No, I don't hunt. That's plebeian work.
So where did you get access to wine of such quality?
I mean, if you need wine, you're going to come to me. I know all the finest winemakers in the land.
How did you come to meet all these contacts?
Oh, we've all met here in town. Some of them we've run into professionally and got to talking and a little something over dinner, and all of a sudden I'm in a cult.
I think she meant your contacts for acquiring wine. Is that what she meant?
Or just everything in general, because you seem
how
to
did you meet everyone?
Yeah,
you
everyone
seem to be able
met.
To acquire all kinds of goods. Did you grow up in a rich family?
Well, I don't know if I can acquire all goods. Why do you say that?
You seem to be proud of your ability to...
To what?
Oh, sorry. He kicked me. I thought he was trying to stop me.
No. My foot was just falling.
Yeah. We're about to get an X.
I'm just overall impressed by this feast you put in front of us. I'm just curious on how you met all your contacts.
What do my contacts have to do with this feast?
A world star chef? An amazing sommelier? How do you meet all these people?
What's a sommelier?
Wine dude.
Wine dudes.
Well, I mean, I don't want to brag, but maybe they're not all people that I've met.
He knows people. He knows people. That's what he's saying.
So let's take a minor break from the role playing and let's see. I'm curious, what all do you have? Do you want to share with me? As the DM?
Yes.
I have a pretty strong theory.
Let's hear it.
These, I agree with it. These are the sins. The seven sins.
Seven sins. All right. What makes you think that?
I think their personalities. Their general mannerisms and their attitudes make me think that they're the sins.
Okay. How do we all feel about that?
Okay. I like it. I'm flip-flopping between some of them.
There's two that I'm...
I might not agree with the handle one either.
Oh, so you have, like, assigned sins?
Yeah.
Let's hear them. Again, this is out of the game.
Yeah.
I think
this is like
time out.
Yeah. I think Horfin is gluttony. I think Reed is greed.
Hold on a second. I mean, I'm not checking anything. I'm okay, go ahead.
I think Horfin is gluttony. I think Reed is greed. I think Vandis is envy. I think Dubel is sloth. I think Saldia is lust. And I'm... I think the only two that I'm flip-flopping on, because I haven't really heard anything that strikes me, is who is pride. Sometimes Handel sounds very proud. Sometimes, what's his name? Parthol sounds very proud. That last conversation. So we'll have a conversation. I'll go. That sounds proud.
And it seems to fit with the goal of finding their driving ambition, if you will, and their actual jobs. I mean, there might be a few other ideas for actual jobs, but I think that's their driving ideals.
I think that Handel is probably closer to pride.
He sounds very proud. When he has the conversation like,
I could handle the dragon.
But at the same time, wrath might feel that way.
I don't think wrath would. I think wrath is actually the little girl.
Yeah.
I can think that wrath is girl. He's pride.
You want to think that envy's the girl? Her attitude about that other character.
Well, who do you have Reed as then?
Reed is
greed.
I think envy's the girl because in the beginning they were all like, she's the toughest. Right?
I want to say envy's Reed.
Okay. I don't think so.
Why do you say that?
He seems to
try
to one-up people, but is not able to. I think the girl is probably Wrath.
She's like looking at a little boy who just want to rip off his face.
I'm just imagining Annie,
and then the dude Tibbers, definitely.
That's all I'm thinking. I think that's where he's going for it, with the girl with. And I think Handel's pride.
I think so too.
But
I don't know who Envy would be.
I thought Envy was maybe Reed.
Yeah, because he's like,
I'm really jealous.
He wants everything.
I know, he's the low man on the totem pole.
So, right, he's envious.
Yeah, that's why he's envious.
But greed is also the same kind of desire. I want more power. Yeah, I want more everything. You just have to have I want to have what they have.
When we were doing the food thing, he wanted what I was eating.
Right.
Yeah. So just like I envious
think
of my food.
There's also greed of it. Yeah. I already know that. I don't think Parthol's gluttony. You know, gluttony is asleep. Gluttony is Horfin. I mean,
gluttony might be Horfin.
No, sloth. Gluttony is Horfin.
Yeah, I agree with that one.
I think greed is greed, personally.
I think greed is envy.
I know.
I think Parthol is Greek.
Where are we at on jobs?
Maybe.
Well, I think Satalia is a whore.
Parthol might
mistress. Be. Mistress. But she is rich and powerful.
She said specifically she doesn't get paid for her pleasures, so could be mistress. But she said her job does involve her pleasures. So.
That's why I thought she was a mistress.
Yeah. What else did she say about that?
Pulling her community. Yeah. And she likes people.
Everything involves her pleasures.
Yeah, I think just...
Everything involves... So she has sex with everything?
I didn't get that. Maybe not.
Then I don't think that was so. The hint.
Yeah. Yep. Okay, so what else you got?
Reed seems like he's like a thief.
Like a fence? I'm thinking fence. That's what I'm going for.
But he hinted that he broke into Federico's house.
Like a thief slash fence. I don't know. Keep going with.
But you could sell to him like upper higher tier thief, basically. Parthol, I don't know if there's an equivalent to a caterer.
I don't think he's a caterer.
I know. Says he, it just seemed like
he gets a lot of FaceTime.
Was it
Kane? So I don't know, yeah, like, was he some kind of...
Role, I had to pay two life, so I was like, I'm
not... I don't know.
Right, so you guys think Horfin's gluttony.
Yeah.
He's like, we're going back to this.
Reed is envy.
Envy.
Handel's pride. Uh-huh. And Vandis is wrath.
Yeah.
It's not entirely out of the possibility.
Well,
and it does solve my issue.
Craft, while we're discussing this, craft some specific questions that will be like very like...
That's why I gave you all a break.
Yeah, a little arrow to...
Can you tell it's around the right track?
No.
Okay. Oh, that's... Oh, I'm just wondering.
Because their motivation
ask.
Is actually like what their favorite foods are.
Huh?
No, I'm just messing with you. You haven't even asked what they're eating.
So yeah, Parthol seems like... Like someone important,
like a politician, like writing down. I don't think Vindas has a job. She's a little, she's eight.
B word.
Brat. She needs Brat. She needs Brat.
A little Brat.
Yeah.
I think she has some kind of magical powers.
I think she's a spy.
Because she spies on the little boy next door. That's awesome.
I don't know about Dubo. So maybe a mercenary is what I got.
I mean, I was thinking like a...
Like a woodchuck. I mean, like a craftsman. He just says like...
Or like a
bodyguard. Well, he has so many like burns and scars. I was thinking like a mercenary.
He just fell asleep before I could really talk
about it. I didn't get merchant out of him. For Dubo.
I was thinking
bodyguard.
Hoffer and I wrote merchant.
He says that he works for people.
That's why I said mercenary. Because people hire him.
Because of the scars. I mean, you don't get scars from like...
Question mark? Merchant? Question mark?
You do if you really
Fence?
Cat.
Question mark?
But like beast scars? Like
I feel like when I first heard about him, he sounded barbarianish.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I didn't say beast scars. I never said that.
Okay.
Just so you
know. It's the scars from work.
That was the mental picture.
Yeah. Had amount.
Wow.
I'm glad I got that cleared up.
Did not say beast scars.
I'm sticking with my mercenary.
Did not.
That's true. That is also true.
Horfin seems like a merchant.
That's what I wrote. Merchant.
Top tier. Okay, so
now, also, while you're conversing with these people, you can try to like inspect or check or do dice roll things too.
That makes things easier.
If you see things that you might be able to,
you intimidate.
That is a thing you can do. However, if you intimidate them into trying to answer a question they won't answer, it might be bad.
We'll get two X's.
I know. That's why I've been hesitant to intimidate.
I don't know. Handle hasn't.
So they're just. Yeah, they're kind of like
job. We're trying to get this job too, right?
Mm-hmm.